to share one of my favorite natural skincare products that I've been using for years now. Aging is part of nature, but I like to take care of my body and mind in the same way. So I like to incorporate little rituals to cuddle my skin, and using natural product is part of it. Rosehip oil have so many benefits and is great for more than one skin types. It's a dry oil and absorbs very quickly on the skin and contains lots of vitamins A, C, fatty acid. As an anti-aging, is good for wrinkles and visibly reduce the fine lines of the skin. It's also good to reduce the inflammation after the sunburn and for dry and damaged skin, and it's great for scars. You can use it on your hair too, but on my hair I prefer to use more fatty oils. I like to use Rosehip oil as a serum, like 4 to 5 drops before wearing my moisturizer, and if I want to use makeup, I just use a couple of drops. If you are not used to put oils on your face, you can just do a relaxing massage a couple of times a week. And remember that before using any natural product, you always want to do a patch test before, so put a little drop on your skin and see if you are allergic or not. My night routine is pretty simple. I just use a little bit of cleansing milk with the water because my mascara come off with water, so it's easy to remove. I'm currently using this cleansing milk that I found in a local supermarket, and it's completely natural, but most of the time I just use a face soap. So what I like to do is just to put a little bit on my hand and to massage it on my face. Then I'm gonna take a little bit of water, because this mascara come off with water, so it's better like that. And then I rinse it off. I just like to tap the towel on my face. I don't want to rub it, otherwise you just damage your skin. And I don't do it every day, I just do it like once or twice a week. Scrub, a face scrub. Sometimes I do in the shower, sometimes I do it just here before to put a mask. When I do the scrub, I always put a mask because I want to nourish the skin and don't want to let the skin dry. So I just gonna take a little bit of water and dump it in my face. And then if you have a really delicate skin, don't push too hard with your fingers, and also you can mix it with a little bit of oil, can be olive oil, almond oil, any light oil. I don't like to use coconut oil on my face too much, besides using it as a sunscreen. And then you can just rinse it off. So what I like to do now is to put a little bit of under eye cream and around my mouth to protect my skin from the mask, because usually the mask is a little bit aggressive on the skin around your eye area and your mouth area. So you can either put an eye cream or just a little bit of oil, any oil. In this case, I suggest you the Rosehip oil. Actually, I'm gonna do it. I'm gonna use the Rosehip oil around my mouth. And in this period, I'm using this one from Antipod. It's a Manuka honey mask, and I like it because it's nourishing, and also the smell is beautiful. It's really sweet, like vanilla, and I like it. But sometimes I just use honey, or I make something in the kitchen, because also fruits and honey and yogurt are a great face mask if you combine the ingredients in the right way. So you can put it properly, or you can just do like me and put it with your fingers. What I like to do is just relax for 10-15 minutes with music or with a book, and then rinse off. Before to rinse it off, I like to massage it a little bit of the skin. So I just take a little bit of water and I start to massage my skin with the mask, so I will absorb more of the nutrients. Yeah, never forget your neck, but in this video I just did the face, so you can do this in the shower or in the bathtub, where you feel more relaxed to do it. At this point, what I like to do is to put a little bit of under eye cream, always, if I have it. If I don't have it, I just use shea butter or rosehip oil or whatever I have at home. I just using this one, also from the supermarket, and also completely natural. And be very gentle under your eye. I just use this finger because it's the weakest finger. Sorry if I can't breathe sometimes, but you cannot tell now, but I'm 9 months pregnant, so it's a bit hard to breathe sometimes. But and now I'm gonna use the rosehip oil. This is from Essano. It's a New Zealand brand and I love it. I'm just using 5 drops. And I put a little bit everywhere. But at least where I think I need it the most. I help myself with a little bit of shea butter, or in this case I'm using this, which is my DIY cream, and you can find the video, I will link it down below, on how I make this cream. It's very easy. I like to do this because it's just a cuddle, and it make me feel relaxed. Don't be scared to massage your face with your hands, with your fingers, because you need to improve the circulation in order for the skin to be healthy and glowing. You will not gonna damage it, so voilà, that's it. My night skincare routine is pretty simple, and I hope you enjoyed this video. Thank you for watching. Ciao!